When you travel across this great land, you realize every state has its own personality, a spirit formed from its history, its people, from its landscape. When the first Europeans landed on the shores of New Hampshire, that spirit was forged by the desire to be free. Something easily taken for granted, sometimes has to be fought for. That bold, assertive independence was on display when Paul Revere rode into Portsmouth in 1774, and it still flows through this land today. From the Balsam's Ballroom of Dixville Notch, when its residents are the first in the country to vote every election, to the 4x4s exploring its countryside, that spirit is embodied in New Hampshire's motto, to live free or die. Sounds harsh, I know. But the truth is, New Hampshire can teach us how to truly live, to reestablish that sense of adventure, of exploration, to get back to nature. And no better place to do that than a trip to the White Mountains, to get a little wet in the Swift River, to walk along the boardwalks in Meredith, take a cruise on Lake Winnipesaukee, to drive along the Kankamagas Highway, experience the trails of Franconia Notch State Park, or take a train ride along the Pemigewasset River, or the Saco River Valley, or ride aboard the Mountaineer through Crawford Notch. In this video, we'll show you Meredith, Weirs Beach, Lincoln, Conway, and Bethlehem. Next week, we'll show the coastal regions of Portsmouth, Dover, and Hampton. We'll give you travel tips along the way. It's time to get back to nature as we explore New Hampshire, land of adventure. We start our adventure in the foothills of the White Mountains, the Lake Winnipesaukee region. At 21 miles long and ranging from 1 to 9 miles wide, Lake Winnipesaukee is the largest lake in New Hampshire. There is an 81-mile loop drive that takes you around the lake. However, we are only showing the south part of the lake. We start at Laconia on Route 3, which runs along the Paugusk Bay. Route 3 is one of the more scenic highways. It parallels I-93 and runs all the way up to Lincoln, eventually into Maine. At times, it runs along the Pemigewasset River. Paugusk Bay is popular for both cold and warm water fishing. On the Weirs Channel at Winnie Marine, you can rent pontoons. Next to Winnie Marine is the Weirs Drive-In Theater. The Logs of Fun Mini Golf on the other side of the channel. The Weirs Channel leads into Lake Winnipesaukee at Weirs Beach. It's a little cold out today, so the beach is empty. But this is a pretty happening place in warmer weather. A nice pedestrian walkway along the Weirs Beach waterfront. The Dive, a unique floating bar and grill with food, ice cream, drinks, and a fun atmosphere with TVs and music. The Weirs Railroad Station / Boat Launch is where you can board the MS Mount Washington for a scenic dinner cruise. Probably the best way to view not only Mount Washington, but Lake Winnipesaukee. Another great way to view the lake is on the Winnipesaukee Scenic Railroad, with stations both in Weirs Beach and Meredith, operated by Hobo Railroad, which will also show in Lincoln. At times, the train runs right along the edge of the lake. Now, if you really want to experience nature, at the Laconia station, you can book 2- or 4-person rail bikes, where you pedal along a rail line, across a trestle bridge, and to the shores of Lake Winnesquam. At Winnipesaukee Pier, you can get beach tacos at Anthony's Pier Restaurant. There's also shops, a candy store, and pontoon rentals available with no boating license required. Also, lots of fun across the street with Half Moon Penny Arcade and bumper cars, and a variety of shops, spirits and music with blues, rock, and country bands at the Tower Hill Tavern. In between Weirs Beach and Meredith is the Sun Valley Cottages, where we stayed. It is in a forested area, provided a great atmosphere for me while getting some editing done. The cottage itself was spacious enough, comfortable. They stock it with a lot of the things that you need for cooking, eating, etc. and it's walking distance to the Fun Spot, the largest arcade in the world, or so they say, with an indoor mini golf. Sorry I didn't get a video of it, but check it out if you are looking for something to do in the area. Meredith is 5 miles north of Weirs Beach on Route 3. It's a great waterfront town to see the fall colors. Mills Falls offers 4 unique hotels with lakeside lodging. This is the Church Landing, a luxury lakefront lodge, surrounded by a lush garden and lawn on the shores of Lake Winnipesaukee. They have fireplaces, pools, a fitness center, and spa, as well as the Lake House Grill. You can rent boats, canoes, kayaks, paddleboards at the Eagle Activity Center, as well as book boat rides and charters. Meredith has a nice long boardwalk that stretches around the lake. Just really a cozy, rustic little town. Some darn good food at the Town Docks Restaurant and Tiki Bar with lakeside seating right on the boardwalk. An average 3-star hotel stay in Meredith is $166. Of course, can be a little bit more in the fall. If nothing else, it's a great place to just hang out. Waterfront parks with picnic shelters. Bay Point at Mills Falls, a 3-star hotel with the Bay Point Lago Restaurant. In an old rural dining atmosphere. Outdoor dining right on the lake. What a great view. Meredith just has a real nice mixture of foliage and waterfront scenery with mountains in the distance. A vacation destination with plenty of room to breathe. Perhaps a perfect romantic getaway. Across the street from Bay Point, a new Laverack Nature Trail at Hawkins Brook, winding through the wetlands of Lake Winnipesaukee. The trailhead is beside Meredith Village Savings Bank, as well as at the tennis courts at Prescott Park. It's a 1.2-mile round trip and is pet friendly. I'm not married, but if I do get married, I'd consider this town for a honeymoon. We continue on Route 3 as we head up to Lincoln. The Covered Bridge Farm Table in Campton, New Hampshire, offers delicious dining next to the scenic Blair Road Covered Bridge. An even more scenic route from Campton to Lincoln is Route 175. In Lincoln, the first stop you want to make is at the White Mountains Visitor Center. You can get good information for what to do in the White Mountains. At the Hobo Scenic Railroad's Lincoln Station, for $19, you can ride in a restored vintage rail coach for an 80-minute round trip along the winding Pemigewasset River on a rail system that dates back to the late 1800s. From mid-September to late October is a great way to see the fall foliage. The trains operate late May through October, and then again from Thanksgiving through late December, when the Santa Express trains operate on weekends. The Pemigewasset River is 65 miles long and runs from Franconia Notch State Park, flows through the White Mountains, and merges with the Winnipesaukee River. After or before the train ride, you can play a round of golf at the Hobo Hills Adventure Golf at the station. The brand new Riverwalk Resort at Loon Mountain in the base camp of the White Mountains with balconies overlooking the mountains. Very close to lots of hiking trails, as well as walking distance to lots of great restaurants, or wineries like the Atrium, or breweries like the One Love Brewery. The Loon Mountain Ski Resort has a vertical drop of 2,100 feet, 10th largest in New England, top elevation at 3,000 feet. The East Branch and Lincoln Railroad was a logging railroad that operated from 1893 to 1948 in the Pemigewasset Wilderness. Enjoy a dinner theater at Gene's Playhouse. In Franconia Notch State Park, for $16, you can tour the Flume Gorge via a walkway with bridges, waterfalls, and scenic mountain views. The path takes about 1.5 hours to do. You walk through walls of granite that rise 70 to 90 feet high and are 12 to 20 feet apart. Pets are not allowed here, though. There are several good nature trails in Franconia Notch Park. Further south in Lincoln, near the Kankamagas Highway, which we will show in a minute, is the Lincoln Woods Trail. This is considered the gateway to the Pemigewasset Wilderness. These trails are stunningly beautiful. I would highly recommend experiencing these trails to see many waterfalls like the Franconia Falls. Most of these trails are dog friendly. The Clark's Bears Amusement Park was one of the few attractions closed due to COVID, but plans to reopen Memorial Day 2021. This is a must-do. It features the Anaconda Escape, a water raft ride through 300 feet of twists and turns, drops and plunges, blaster boats, a circus, a climbing tower, a 30-minute train ride, and its very popular bear show with live trained bears. General admission is $24. During May through November, you can enjoy a 5-course gourmet meal on a scenic train ride. On the Lafayette Dinner Train, from December through April, the depot is a tapas and wine bar. The Kankamagas Highway runs from Lincoln to Conway. While we are headed to Conway, and we'll show it in a minute, because of the angle of the sun and the time of day, we're going to show this highway going from Conway to Lincoln. Kankamagas was an Indian leader. His name means the fearless one. This is probably the most scenic highway in the U.S. in the fall. It was opened in 1959. It travels along the Swift River coming out of Conway. To really fully appreciate this drive, you have to get out of the car and get along the rocks of the Swift River. The fall colors begin around mid-September, but really peaks about the second week of October. We are driving it on October 8th. The lower falls are about 7 miles west of Conway. This time of year, the water level is lower, so it really allows you to jump out into the river to get close to the white water. There is also a nice sheltered pavilion, picnic area, so you can have lunch with the family. Now, if you are born to be wild, ride the Kankamagas on a bike. It takes about 50 minutes to drive from Conway to Lincoln with no stops. This is not a highway to be in a rush. Take your time and enjoy. And that's coming from Mr. Leadfoot here. The summit is at 2,800 feet. Both sides of the summit, just a great drive. Conway is the biggest city in the White Mountains. Conway is where the Saco River and the Swift River meet at the Saco River Covered Bridge. Biking and walking trails at the Whitaker Woods Park near the railroad tracks. 700-foot high Cathedral Ledge and White Horse Ledge, located in Echo Lake State Park, are popular for rock climbing. Or you can take a mile-long auto road that leads to the top for great views across the Saco River Valley to the White Mountains. The Echo Lake area is popular for hiking, kayaking, canoeing, fishing. North Conway is probably the center of entertainment for the White Mountains. Its most popular attraction, the Conway Scenic Railway. This is the Bartlett Excursion Train, returning from a 21-mile, hour and 45-minute trip. One of three separate train rides Conway Scenic Railroad offers. All trips start and return from the Victorian-style station built in 1874. The longest trip, a 5-hour mountaineer excursion, which we'll show later in the video. The Conway Valley Heritage Rail Excursion is the shortest ride, an 11-mile, 55-minute trip through the valley across the Swift River. Across from the railroad station is a rustic, quaint New England-style North Conway Village with tax-free shopping. Another reason why I love this state. New Hampshire is one of 5 states with no sales tax. There are many nice little cafes like Peach's Restaurant, known for great coffee. You see the line. A blueberry crisp drive-thru at the First Church of Christ. Zeb's General Store, an old-fashioned New England store. farm-to-table dining at Chef's Bistro. A couple of blocks north of the station is the Eastern Slope Inn Playhouse with entertaining theatrical performances. We ate multiple times at this Thai restaurant, one of three Thai restaurants on White Mountain Highway. The food was delicious. We stayed at the pet-friendly Yankee Clipper Inn and was pretty happy. We saw it had a negative review about being an older hotel, but really, I had no issues. Everything worked, a good clean room. If you want a newer hotel, then maybe this hotel is not for you. If you want a decent place at a decent price, I'd recommend it. Good location. If you're looking for something a little more fancy, you may want to try the Adventure Suites Hotel. Each suite has a fun, unique theme. Like the Train Depot here, this looks like a fun hotel you may want to check out. If visiting during the fall, you really want to book ahead. We couldn't because we were planning our trip based upon when the sun was shining, so could only book a few days prior. We got lucky because many pet-friendly places had no vacancy. We now head further into the White Mountains, showing you some lodging that is closer to Mount Washington. The Covered Bridge House Bed and Breakfast next to the Bartlett Covered Bridge. About a 37-minute drive to the Cog Railway. This bed and breakfast is literally right on the Saco River. The bridge no longer carries car traffic, but is a gift shop with a distinctive collection of home decor items. A couple of miles up the road, the Attitash Mountain Village at the base of the ski resort. Many units with kitchens, fireplaces, spa tubs, and a great mountain view. The Attitash area has biking, kayaking, fishing, ice skating. The village resort has an indoor and outdoor pools, playgrounds, tennis courts, fitness facilities with sauna and hot tubs. The Villager Motel, just 15 minutes to Crawford Notch State Park and 34 minutes to the Cog Railway. A mile up the road in Bartlett Village is the Cabin Fever Restaurant. Another half mile is the Bartlett Inn and Cottages, just 32 minutes to the Cog Railway. These cottages are pet-friendly and a delicious homemade breakfast each morning. I'm giving you the distance to the Cog Railway because if you want to ride the steam locomotive up Mount Washington, it leaves at 7:30 in the morning. So it's nice to have lodging as close to it as possible so you don't have to get up so early. Route 302 runs from Conway through the White Mountains and Crawford Notch, all the way to Littleton where it connects with I-93. 302 was part of the Teddy Roosevelt Trail, which ran from Maine to Oregon. It was an important way for the tourists to access the White Mountains. After the 1927 floods, many bridges needed to be quickly replaced. This is the Pierce Bridge, called a High Pratt Truss Bridge. It was commonly used back then because it was strong and easy to construct. This riveted steel span was erected in 1928. Outside of the National Park in Crawford Notch State Park. We hike up to the Silver Cascade. To be honest, it's not much of a hike. It's located right off the road. An impressive 600-foot drop over a series of cascades. The Flume Cascade is also on the other side of US 302. And look who's coming through the mountains. It's Conway Scenic Railway's Mountaineer. The Mountaineer consists of 1950s-era streamlined passenger cars, giving you the experience of post-World War II-era railway, a 50 to 60-mile round trip that goes through Mount Washington Valley and Crawford Notch. It stops at the Crawford Notch Station. A Queen Anne-style architecture built in 1891, formerly the main Central Passenger Railway Station. It is also a visitor center for the Appalachian Mountain Club. During the fall foliage season, the Mountaineer also goes up to Fabian's Station, another 4 miles up US 302. You can choose a variety of different experiences on the Mountaineer, traveling in the deluxe Rhonda Lee Upper Dome dining car for $119. Or the Dorothea May Dome is $88. Or premium class with plush seating is $82. Coach is $62. You can also book a first class, which includes lunch, for $107. Add $5 to all options during fall foliage season. Fabian's Station is also a seasonal lounge serving pub food for lunch and dinner. Here, the Mountaineer reverses direction so that it can head back through Crawford Notch and to Conway. Also at Fabian's Station is the road to the Cog Railway. This is the first mountain climbing clog and the only one in North America. It climbs a steep grade at 25% to 38%. It usually only climbs to 6,200 feet to the summit of Mount Washington from about May to about the third week of October. In colder months, it just goes to Wambach Station, located just below 4,000 feet. The round trip to the summit on the biodiesels is just under 3 hours, with an hour stop at the top. The trip with the steam engine slightly longer. The round trip to Wambach Station is about an hour with a 25-minute stop, with complimentary hot refreshments, warming huts, and a fire pit. Across from Fabian Station is Drummond's Mountain Shop, a ski and snowboard rentals, as well as hiking gear, clothing. The last stop on our journey is the highest elevated town east of the Rockies, Bethlehem. It sits on the north edge of the White Mountains, given its name because it was incorporated on Christmas Day in 1799. This is one of those towns that was not on our list, but was just so impressed going through. As you can see, strikingly beautiful. A food coffee eatery I highly recommend is the Maya Papaya, probably the best coffee and pumpkin muffin I have had on the whole trip. A nice little outdoor seating area too amidst beautiful trees. Bethlehem is one of those quaint small towns right out of a Thomas Kincaid painting. If you want to lodge here, there is the Hearthside Village Cottage Motel, or the Presidential Mountain Resort on Miller Pond. Again, just great scenery. Like those in New Hampshire's history, may we live our lives by that same fearless nature to push forward. Freedom is a great blessing. May we cherish it and fight for it when we need to live life to the full. Perhaps a trip to the White Mountains may be the very thing to show us how to live free. As much as we showed in the video, there was so much we didn't show. I'd love it if you can share a trail, a resort, an experience in the White Mountains or Lake Winnipesaukee that you had. We are Tampa Aerial Media. We shoot travel promos across the USA. For licensing or stock footage, contact us at info@tampaaerialmedia.com. Next week, we go to the coast of New Hampshire and see some of the very first settlements of the Granite State. Thank you for watching, and blessings to you wherever you may be.